Hey, my name is Natasha. You're watching Something About Movies, and this is my review for Horrible Bosses. Okay, so Horrible Bosses stars Jason Bateman, Jason Sudeikis, and Charlie Day as three average guys who pretty much hate their bosses for different reasons, and one day they decide to kill them. Jason Bateman plays a guy who works at a corporate office, and he's been working there a long time and working really hard trying to get a promotion and putting up with his asshole boss. And then finally it just reaches a point where he realizes that he's not getting the promotion he wants and his boss is an asshole and he wants to do something about it. Kevin Spacey plays his boss and he plays his role really well. He's not just an evil asshole. You can tell that he was just a really miserable person in his personal life, and he takes it out on his employees. Jason Sudeikis plays a pretty blue-collar guy. He actually really likes his job, and he really enjoys what he does. The only problem is that his boss's son is a douchebag, and he pretty much inherits the company when his boss dies. And once he discovers his new douchebag boss's intentions for the company, he realizes that this guy's gotta go. And what better way to do that than to kill him? Jason Sudeikis in this role was okay. I felt like the whole womanizer thing he was doing was kind of forced and it didn't really feel natural. And every time he was in a scene where he was, you know, picking up a girl or something, it was kind of like, oh yeah, and now I'm going to do that. Colin Farrell plays the douchebag boss and he does a really good job. You know, he's got the whole comb over thing going on. He wasn't in the movie too much, but from what he was in, his performance was pretty good. And then there was Charlie Day, who played a dental assistant to a man-eater boss, played by Jennifer Aniston. And I've got to say, I was not impressed with Charlie Day's performance. It was so over the top and exaggerated, and it got old really quick. And I know he's supposed to play like this bumbling idiot, but Zach Galifianakis in The Hangover was more subtle than this guy was in Horrible Bosses. As far as comedy goes, I really felt it was consistently mediocre. The laughs were there, but they weren't like hysterical. And the theater I was in, there was only like one person laughing for most of the jokes and everyone else was silent. And it's a shame because the premise and the situations are really funny and you would think that you could get a lot out of it, but the characters were so one-dimensional and there's something just really stale about it that didn't work for me. There's one scene in particular when they were actually at the bar and just musing about the idea of killing their bosses that was so forced. And I guess the whole point was that they were supposed to be drunk and just, you know, bullshitting about this and not really taking it seriously. But I didn't believe the whole performance of all three of the guys at all in this. It just felt really forced. They were just going through the motions in the dialogue. It just didn't have the effect that it should have had. There were a lot of jokes based on racial stereotypes, and normally I'm not really sensitive to that, but I felt like it was just so out of place here and kind of inappropriate. But as far as what I did like about the movie, I thought Jason Bateman's character was pretty good. It wasn't just the guy who put up with all of his boss's bullshit and complained about it behind his back. He called it when his boss was being a dick, and he would call it when there was something going on that didn't quite add up. And I liked that about his character. The plot also kept you guessing a lot, and there were a lot of times where I was surprised with where the story was going, and it always kept me guessing. But other than that, there was just something missing from this movie. It didn't live up to the potential that it could have had, and I was definitely let down. And because of that, I'm gonna have to give it a 2 out of 4 stars. It was alright, not the funniest movie this year, and you might as well just wait till rental or see it after Zookeeper if you need to pick me up.